Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Little Richard. Woo! And I am Sheila E. Welcome to the Museum of Latin American Music.
We are God's for today's tour. We will have a day full of fun, merit, and fantastic exhibits for you to preview as we make our way through this magical museum of influential artists.
Now, this is the typical museum. Each exhibit will take you through a living, breathing journey, exposing you to the sounds of artists from 1940s to today. Keep your eyes and ears open. You never know what to expect around here.
Our first exhibit is Queen of Salsa, Mambo Afro-Cuban, Celia Cruz. Celia Cruz was born in Havana. Celia Cruz was a Latin music most respected vocalist ever. She was a 10-time Grammy Award, Smithsonian Lifetime Achievement, and recipient and received a National Medal of Arts.
That popularized the rhythm of the dance tip in the known worldwide.
Sopa de Caracol, or Encanto soup in English, is wonderful to listen to and to taste. You get it this time?
No!
Bata vine y managa, si tú quieres bailar, sopa de caracol. Bata negi con su, mi pati y yo mi pati, tu libra mi managa.
Hey, hey.
Bata negi con su, tu libra mi managa.
Con la cintura muevela, con la cadera muevela, si lo que quieres es bailar, si lo que quieres es gozar. Sopa de caracol,
hey, pata negi con su, tu libra mi guanaga.
Pata
negi con su, tu pipa tiyo mi.
panaya, mata winegi con su, mata winegi panaya. Si tú quieres bailar, sopa de caracol.
Our next stop is the Motown's Records Room.
Ooh, I love the Motown sound.
You know they stole most of that music from me, right?
Oh man, I don't believe you.
It's true, it's true. I remember like it was 1964. I was eating on a hamburger and I almost choked too. I said, Cletus, he said, what?
Huh, enough, would you stay on topic?
Child hush. Well, here's someone you should all know. Michael Joseph Jackson. Recorded and released a cover of Rockin' Robin in 1972, taken from his gold-certified solo album titled Got to Be There. Rockin' Robin was written by Leon Renee under the pseudonym of Jimmy Thomas and recorded by Bobby Day in 1958. It was Day's only hit single.
Several hit singles such as The One Who Really Loves You, The Way You Do, The Things You Do, My Girl, Since I Lost My Baby, and the popular hit song Mickey's Monkey.
Wait, who?
Stevie Wonder!
Oh, I never knew his real name. Well, among Wonder's best known works, the single Superstitious and I Just Called to Say I Love You, when he was 13, his major hit song was Fingertips. Until I was 13, y'all got any music up? Woo!
She gained her first high-profile job as a fly girl on In Living Color in 1991. I think I could jazz just like her. She meant to enter the music industry in 1999 with her debut studio album, On the Six. Her 2002 album, J to the L-O, The Remixes, became the first in history to debut at number one on the US Billboard 200.
Thank you.
Jeffrey Royce Rojas, known by his stage name Prince Royce, is an American singer and songwriter from the Bronx. The singles Stand By Me, Corazon, and Sin Cara, a Bongo Bachata version of the legendary song by Ben E. King, became a worldwide hit that took him to the top both pop and R&B stations in the U.S. Royce released his third full-length album, Soy El Mismo, featuring Snoop Dogg, Jennifer Lopez, and Pitbull. Define a generation. Aretha Franklin cover of the hit song Respect rose to the top both pop and R&B charts and earned herself two Grammy Awards. Rolling Stone eventually declared R-E-S-P-E-C-T the fifth greatest song of all time, earning Aretha the title the Queen of Soul.
It's falling respect when you jump.
Just a little bit.
Oh yeah.
a little respect now. Our next performer was a pioneer in soul music. During the 1950s, he fused the music genres of jazz, gospel, and blues to create his own style of rhythm and blues. Ray Charles Robinson became the first African-American musician to be given complete artistic control by a mainstream record company. Charles reached the pinnacle of his success at Atlantic Records with the release of What I Say. favorites. His career spans over 5 decades in the entertainment industry.
I know him by Cuba. Quincy Delight Jones Jr. worked in the 1960s as an arranger for Sarah Vaughan, Frank Sinatra, Ray Charles, and Ella Fitzgerald. In 1971, Jones received the honor of becoming the first African American to be named music director and conductor of the Academy Award ceremony.
Tour. This artist is a Spanish MC, DJ Tremendo, as he is known in the industry, was born in Eduardo Lopez Guerrero, aka Tremendo Mendo.
He belongs to the Barcelona collective Funko Mona. In 2001, he joined the Del Palo that released his single El Loco Soy Yo. In 2004, the album was highly acclaimed to several media, both for its productions, quality, and for its rhymes.
Thank you.
If you look to your left, you will find our final exhibit combines Latin American music, Don Omar, and one of reggaeton's first international superstars, Jorge Hector Ruiz, known by the stage name of Sabu. He is an Argentine singer and actor who recorded more than 15 albums and over 200 songs to create one of the style's first genuine reggaeton crossover hits.
Bop, 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 bop